Hello students. At first you read the chapter carefully and then listen to me. It will help you to understand the summary very well. In the chapter, The Best Christmas Present in the World, the main character describes his experience about the war camp to his wife. Before we move further, let me tell you about the author, Sir Michael Morpurgo. He is an English book author, poet, playwright, lyricist, and best known for writing children's novels. There are different characters in this chapter. The author, second, Jim MacPherson, he is an army man. Third, Connie, his wife. Fourth, Fritz, which are German soldiers. And Tommy, these are British soldiers. Let's begin. The author visited a junk shop. Junk shop means where you can find the waste materials in Bridgeport, and found an old roll top desk. It was a time of early 19th century and he had wanted one, but they were far too expensive. One of them was in bad condition, but it was cheap, so he thought to purchase it. It's one of his leg was clumsily mended. It means awkwardly repaired. It had scorch marks all down one side. Scorch marks, there are the burn marks. It seemed as this furniture has been taken out from any house which might have caught fire. He thought he would buy and be able to repair it. So on Christmas Eve, he began to restore it. He began to work on it. He removed the roll top and pulled out the drawers. You know, the roll top desk is a desk having sliding cover. And he tried to pull out drawers one by one. The last drawer could be opened forcibly as it was stuck. And a secret compartment lay within it. He was surprised. It contained even a little teeny box on the top, which was written, James' last letter received January 25, 1915, to be buried with me when the time comes. An envelope in the box had the address, Mrs. Jean MacPherson, 12 Copper Beaches, Bridgeport, Dorset, and it was dated December 26, 1914. The author knew that the owner of the desk must have put the letter in it. Despite himself, he could not stop himself from reading it, though we know that it's not a good manner to open anybody's letter. But he was curious to see what was written. It had been written by Captain Jim MacPherson of the British Army to his wife, Connie. Jim narrated a fascinating event which occurred in the battlefield on Christmas Day. The World War first had begun. The British and the Germans were at war, and the two armies lay in trenches on both sides of no man's land. What are trenches? These are the ditches in the ground where soldiers hide from the enemy. Trenches are the long, deep beaches in the ground where soldiers hide themselves to protect from the enemy. And what is no man land? It's a area between the two countries or in the border area, which is not under the control of any of the country. So the armies lay on the both sides of the no man's land over there. So what happened later on, I will tell you in the next part. Till then, take care. Goodbye.